If you're already familiar with PID, then check out the Quick Start video where we'll do a quick example without a lot of explanation. If you're not real familiar with PID, or you just want to learn about all the cool features that CLICK PID has to offer you, then this series of videos where we break it down into easy to consume, step-by-step, hands-on tutorials is for you. This video is the overview where we outline what we'll be doing. We'll then take a closer look at the hardware we'll be using. Understanding your hardware is the first key to getting a successful PID implementation. Next, we'll see how to configure the CLICK PLC for PID using the graphical user interface that walks you step by step through setting up PID. Then, we'll find out what the hardware can do, do an auto-tune, and run a bunch of examples to see how well we did. Auto-tune can struggle if you have something odd going on in your system or a noisy process variable, for example. So it's always nice to have a manual tuning method in your toolbox. In this video, we'll show you a quick and easy way to manually tune a reliable and stable PID system without having to play the PID guessing game and hoping you get close enough. In all of the previous videos, we manually changed the set point. Well, PID is great for tracking processes, so in this video, we'll build a little ramp soak function and then use it to feed PID so PID can automatically track the ramp soak and give us a nice, clean, repeatable, and reliable temperature profile. And finally, we'll use this video to back up and take a closer look at the features we glossed over or skipped to save time in the previous videos. And some of the bigger topics will be covered in our own bonus videos. Well, if you're ready to get started, then click here to see all of the videos in this series. Click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos. And click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free, award-winning tech support options.